It is admittedly way too early to be thinking about who hypothetically might be running in the Republican primary next time. But some people make it abundantly clear that that's what they're planning for. If you're one of those lucky individuals who's been following Secretary Pompeo on Twitter, they have just been posting like PR stuff for him the last couple, like it has nothing to do with his job at all. So here's an example, and you tell me what this really has to do with being Secretary of State. Here's one of the last tweets that will ever go out from his time as Secretary of State. Wokeism, multiculturalism, all the isms, they're not who America is. They distort our glorious founding and what this country is all about. Our enemies stoke these divisions because they know they make us weaker. Which is a different quote than the quote in the image, which is censorship, wokeness, political correctness at all points in one direction. Authoritarianism cloaked as moral righteousness. Well, a cloak of moral righteousness is really what that tweet is all about. Francesca, what do you think?
I mean, I woke up to this Nazi-ish. Like, I am sorry. Like, you, like, oh my God. What I think this means is that when he does announce his run in 2024, he will use the N-word. Like it,
because if he doesn't, it's authoritarianism.
If he doesn't, then it's just all this political correctness. Exactly, it is not being a Nazi is Nazism. Do you see how this works? Like this, I mean, what an embattled majority that we have elevated, and we have deluded an already majoritarian, like white, straight, you know, elite, you know, cabal. Like they have deluded everybody that like white genocide is real, and that you not being able to say all your favorite slurs, also why do you have favorite slurs, is somehow like. What is authoritarianism? I mean, like, yeah. I can't believe this stuff. Like the idea, and let's just name it. Multiculturalism and being against that, that is the stuff of far right pseudo populist movements all throughout Europe. This is Steve Bannon stuff. This is, you know, yeah. Nigel Farage stuff. This is Golden Dawn in Greece stuff. This is all the stuff. And like, that's in Europe. That's in Europe that's like been experiencing more waves of migration now. Whereas the United States, I mean, I grew up in the 80s, man. It was like, we are a melting pot. We are a little mixed salad. You're a tomato. I'm avocado. Like, it's just like, it was.
Is that a real song or did you just make that up?
I just made it up. But like,
good freestyle.
Dude, right. I'm telling you, I have multicultural freestyle whenever you want. So
that's not what this show is about, okay? Your freestylisms. Yeah, no, you're 100% right though. The saying multiculturalism is not what America is about is sure, it's like the intro to a Tucker Carlson monologue. But in terms of actual politicians, that's Steve King. Like 5 years ago, were there four Republicans that would have just tweeted, no, I'm against multiculturalism.
Yep.
But now that's just ground floor. I want to run in the primary. So I need to let you know that I think we should only have one culture. Any of them's fine, I'm sure. Just pick one of them at random. But no, that's, and wokeism. Because the Republicans, I'm going to say, do they encapsulate 99% of the actual uses of the word woke in the last year? It's like they're the only persons that are talking about that. But yeah, get ready for that primary, because we had some really nasty debates in 2016. Ooh. You know, like who believes in global warming? Would you let someone die on the street, you know, because they don't have health insurance? But they are going to be even more explicitly fighting each other in a battle royale to prove how heartless, cruel, fascistic, racist they are.
Get ready for Jake Tapper to be like, so with the wokeness, are we talking, would you agree with Secretary Pompeo that they need to all go to work camps? Go. Like this is the normalization that is coming from the US media. Do not let this happen, y'all. I'm still not over the ways that mainstream media normalized Trump, and every single debate was, yeah, but what do you think of Trump's idea? Like, This fool should not be running. This fool is a joke. The wall. But it'll happen. It'll happen. And unless we get better executives, I'm not holding my breath. But then nothing's gonna change.
Oh God, it's gonna get dark. It's gonna get so dark. Just ready. Like, we've moved into a time of more possibility. But all the right's gonna lose it. What the media is gonna be saying, what their politicians are gonna say. Like, Lauren Boebert and Marjorie Taylor Greene got elected. There are so many Republicans that want to duplicate that right now.
But this is why we need multiple parties. This is why we need proportional representation. This is why, you know, when you say the Golden Dawn or you say these European like fascistic, you know, parties, like, yeah, but they have like proportional representation. They have parties. They have multiple parties, not just two. So really the onus is on Republicans. What are they going to do? They're going to cut these crazies loose? They're going to form a new party? Is Bloomberg going to lead the way? I mean, honestly, we're in a very interesting moment.
I'd forgotten about Bloomberg's run.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.